Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, today with us in the game room we have football superstar Marlin Lane. What's going on, man?
Nothing, man. Chill.
That's what's up. So, tell me, man, you was a star in football, but you was also a star in basketball. How did you decide to make that transition, you know, for your current football?
I was playing basketball since, fourth, third grade, and I was all taller than everybody, but as I got older, I stopped growing at my position, only 5'11". Everybody 6'5", 6'6". So I just decided to play, football, because, I like physical stuff, and I just felt that I was I'd get more recognition in football than basketball.
Okay, that's what's up. Before we go on, let me tell you how talented this man was. I was a senior in high school. He came in as either a freshman or eighth grader, and I was starting, When he came, I started riding the bench a little bit more, I ain't mad because the best man won the job, but I'd rather him make that decision when I was a senior that he's gonna play football, so I had a little more playing time. But that just goes to show you how talented he was, though. Coming from Lighthouse, a smaller school, and then going to mainly more of a, powerhouse, going for sports and other stuff, was that a lot of pressure on you?
It was pretty much pressure because everybody thought I couldn't do it at a 6A school rather than doing it at a 1A. So, I just kept my confidence up and let people talk, work out day and night, and just went in and, I performed at the top-notch talent, because I'm competitive. So, like you said, best man win, and I ended up winning the starting job at Marlin High School.
So, along with playing sports, you kept a 3.2 GPA, and that's not easy to do, being a superstar athlete and getting the work done. So how did you manage to do that?
It was hard. It slipped a couple times. I let it drop because practice all day and do my homework, but I made up for it, just studying for an hour each night I get home before I get in the shower. And, it's just coaches stand on me, coaches, parents, and just mentors just stand on me, making me do my work. So, I said I never fell off a team for grades, and I just succeeded off of that.
So from school to the football field, who would you say is the number one person who just, pushes you to succeed in everything?
First God. Without him, I couldn't do all that. He gave everybody different things, to be successful for, and he gave me talent. So I'm going to take that and just run with it while I can. And, every man can't walk, and everybody can't run. So I was blessed from that. And, I got a lot of people know that push me, so father, mom, Coach Bryant, Rose, a lot of people, so it's not that particular one.
So, not only you, but your father, even your granddad, and your little brothers, all y'all are just straight athletes, man. Is that strong bloodline of sports in y'all family that give you a lot of confidence on the field?
Yeah, as I was growing up, my mom's side, my granddad, all of them was talented, tall, they were basketball players, and my dad was side, they were basketball and football players, and it's just too much talent in our family for one of us not to make it anywhere, so I just put down that I'm going to be the one.
So, growing up in D-Land, we got Mikey, Harper and Chantrell, which ones you grew up with, and also you played against, all y'all's football stars, but y'all done took to the next level, and y'all at D1 colleges. How does that feel?
It feels great inside right now, but to see the people that you grew up with, everybody on the same the same page, trying to get to the next level. And just, you know, we just push each other, all of us. I mean, even though we played against each other, we had our little, you know, confidence on and off the field, just playing around about our rival. But far down the line, you know, I'm glad for all of them. You know, one of us, one out of four gonna make it. It'd be better if all four of us make it.
So, you know, you're leaving to go to Tennessee soon, man. You know, what's going through your head? You're gonna be, you know, a whole other place, new people, you know, new team, get used to. What's, you know, what's going on with that?
Just going there, you know, listening. You know, college is gonna be a job. It ain't high school no more. And you can, you know, sleep in our family room and, you know, play around because you know you got that starting position. But everybody blue chip in college, so just, I'm just going there, you know, keeping my mouth closed and just listen, just take down so-called information they give me. And I'm going there, you know, as a true freshman, so August, first game, will be starting because I'm going to work.
So this probably the last time anyone sees you or, you know, hear what you got to say for the league. Leaving tomorrow, so anything you want to say, you know, family, friends?
Well, my family, you know. You know, I get them a grade A because they stay behind me through thick and thin, you know. Even when I was slipping a little bit, even when I was sitting out for 6-7 months from knee surgery, you know, they still by my side making me work. And that goes for my friends too, you know. Everybody have friends, but doesn't nobody have a whole bunch of friends that's gonna, you know, be behind 100% the right way. You know, some friends be jealous, you know, want to lead you a certain way, and you have the other friends that want to see you succeed. So the friends that I got, they help me succeed. You know, and I don't like that because I don't trust a lot of people. So they can have my respect on me.
That's what's up. Y'all in the game room, it's Marlin Lane.
Song dedicated to anybody out there got some dreams. Don't give up on your dreams, real talk. You ready, Keish? Let's go.